Hello, friends of the manga world. My name is Hector.
And my name is G.
And we're here to talk to you about the new releases for manga coming out in October of 2022. Now, for those of you who don't know, G and I work for Penguin Random House. So the titles that we're going to talk about today are titles that we can sell internationally. And also bear in mind that some of the titles, the rights might be they might be restricted in some areas. So if you have any questions, please reach out to us and we'll clarify any questions you might have. So at first we're gonna do some picks, and then we're gonna go into the volume ones of the titles, the volume ones that are coming out in October, and then we'll look at the rest of the list. I do have to mention that there might see some titles that we talked about already in the last video, and that's because, you know, as you know, recently there's been a lot of delays due to production issues. So bear with us with that. So let's just get started. So the first title is one that I picked to talk about. This one is Dissolving Classroom Collector's Edition by Junji Ito. This is obviously Junji Ito is a master of manga horror. And we have several of his books that have recently been, reprinted. Kodansha has reprinted and into Collector's Edition. And this is the next one. This is just one of the weirdest. It is described as one of the weirdest things that he ever wrote, which is a lot to say because Junji Ito writes a lot of weird stuff. It's just a shocking horror story that involves a pair of siblings, a young man obsessed with the devil, and a little sister who, on the description, they call as the worst little sister in recorded history. So there's not much in the description. It's not much to say. It's Junji Ito. It's going to be really good, and it's going to be really scary. That's all I really need to say. Okay? Next.
Next up for my pick is Be Very Afraid of Kananko Inuki by the creator herself. So she is the queen of horror manga. And this is actually a short story collection handpicked by the creator herself, and it includes her original commentary as well. So that's something that you should definitely pick up. The art in this is very creepy. I love it. And so this is another pick that you should, if you're going to pick up Junji Ito, you might as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pick the king and the queen together.
Yeah. Yeah, you have to. They come together.
Yes. And next is Go-Go Loser Ranger 1. I love the premise. This is by Neji Haruba. I love the premise of this book. This is, first of all, the creator of this is the same creator as the quintessential quintuplets. And it is, you know, you take the Power Rangers and you take that kind of story. And in this case, it's the Divine Dragon Rangers. And 13 years ago, an alien race invaded the Earth. So these Divine Dragon Rangers came together to fight them and fight the kaiju that they threw at the Earth. And according to the story, they're still fighting and defending the Earth from these kaiju and this alien invasion 13 years later. But in reality, 5 years into the fight, the Earth won. But the government and the Dragon Rangers kept it a secret. And every week they make the aliens and their kaiju stage fights every week. So for the entertainment of the public, and sort of to kind of show that, you know, that they are defending the Earth and that they're the good guys. But one of the aliens says, I had enough. So he decides to infiltrate the Rangers and try to take them down from inside. So it's going to be a lot of action. It's going to be very funny for fans of Power Rangers, for fans of kaiju. I think this is a perfect book And I really, it does mention that's going to be a lot of funny references. So I'm really looking forward to that too. So this is something that comes out in October. I highly recommend it.
And next up, no surprise here. This is not going to be the first time, nor the last time.
Nor the last
time. This. This is Sweat and Soap. This is the manga box set one by Kintetsu Yamada. I love the series so much. I talk to Hector about it all the time. It's great. It's about Asako, who is self-conscious because she sweats a lot profusely and she's worried about her scent. And she loves using toiletry products from this one company that she also works for. And so as she's looking at the new line of products in the company lobby, her scent gets it gets sniffed by one of the product developers who is very enamored by her scent. And then he has to get to know her because her scent is an inspiration for him to create new products for future lines. And so it's a very weird story, but it's so good. It's so good. I've devoured this when I started reading this. I had to read all of it. And so now we have this box set. Now, the cool thing about this box set that I forgot to mention before, it's very important. This comes with an exclusive scented stickers. And I like that it comes with scented stickers because that's lovely. So definitely pick up this box set. I will for sure because I've been waiting for it to drop. And of course, this releases in October.
Yes. Next up for something different. PTSD, well, not really different. This is another horror, very weird story. And it's PTSD Radio 1. Actually, it's Volume 1 and 2 together by Masaaki Nakayama. And this is another very strange story. In this case, it's something from old Japan comes to modern Japan, shows up, and it haunts the world and humans, and it has puts a curse around all living things. And people don't know what it is, but the only thing they know is that the curse lives in human hair. So all of a sudden, there are these really dark attacks to humans and other living things from hair. So in a description, it mentions like an unseen hand tugs at your braid. You find an old box with only a tangled mess of dark hair inside, or you open a door in your home and only witness a river of curls slinking away. It's such a creepy idea and so awesome. I think it's going to be very, very, very scary, very cool, but also there are some amazing images, and we have a couple of interior images to show you here. Some of them are in color and then the rest is in black and white. This is such a creepy thing. And I love that on the right side, you have this creepy thing, but, you know, just a carton of milk in a glass next to it and the beach behind, the radio with teeth, and I guess it's bleeding. It's, you know, it's right up my alley. It's perfect for Halloween. I think that we have another image, right? Mm-hmm. Yep. I mean, look at that. Just a bunch of hands reaching out for you. That's and it's like up high on a building, and we have these these amazing scary faces, you know, with horrifying eyes and the hair, obviously. So very creepy, very fun. I think this is going to be beautiful and horrifying at the same time.
Very cool. Yes. And then shifting
gears. And shifting gears. For something completely different.
Yeah, this is A Galaxy Next Door, Volume 3 by Amagakuri. I am so sorry. And this one is interesting. So it's about this manga creator who lost his parents, and now he has to take care of his siblings and is struggling because, you know, doesn't get paid very much and has to make ends meet. And a lot of his assistants start quitting on him as well because they want to follow their own dreams as well. And so he needs to find a new assistant, and he ends up finding one who you'll see her on the front cover here. And something, this, not to get into spoilers, but some series of circumstances happen where, like, suddenly they're kind of in this marriage now, even though they like barely know each other. It makes more sense as you're reading through, but I can't reveal because it's a huge spoiler. It makes more sense with the spoiler on how that happens. It's like a really sweet, she's very sweet, naive, and it's like a wholesome manga. In fact, if you like Sweat and Soap, which clearly I like, you'll definitely be a fan of this as well. So this is definitely a pickup that you'd want to pair along with Sweat and Soap for sure. So yeah, so one of my picks for this month or October.
Yes. And we'll continue, like I mentioned before, with volume ones. Mm-hmm. And it's great because you'll see we have other things other than the horror and sweet, you know, romance. So first off on this slide, you see volume one, some of the volume ones coming on October. We have Black and White, Tough Love at the Office, volume one, Sparks and Fists Fly in this violent jury love story. I love that description and the cover. Next up is Candy and Cigarettes, volume one, an action-packed neo-noir revenge thriller from the creator of Chameleon. And next we have Sweet Life Fantasy Online, Mortal Princess, this is the manga, volume one, lose yourself in a new world of ghoulish adventure in this fantasy gaming tale, and don't miss the original light novels, also from Seven Seas. And on the far right, Hunting in Another World with My Elf Wife, manga, volume one, a fantasy isekai about a Hokkaido hunter and the beautiful elf huntress he meets in another world.
Mm-hmm. And then continuing on with volume one, we have I Got Fired as a Court Wizard, So Now I'm Moving to the Country to Become a Magic Teacher, manga, volume one. I love that title.
Yes, definitely.
As the title implies, you can probably get the premise of it just from that. A powerful mage finds himself teaching a class of misfits and oddballs in this lighthearted fantasy. It sounds like a lot of fun. Next up, coming out in October, we have Imaginary Volume 1, which is a gorgeously illustrated tale about childhood friends, unrequited love, and the power of imagination. I love the ponderous faces that each character has. You can see their personalities definitely portrayed in the cover. And then we have Katana Gatari. This is the light novel, volume one. And this story brings to life a swordless swordsman and a self-described schemer who embarks on a quest to obtain 12 peculiar masterpiece blades. So if you're a fan of this author's work, Nisi Osen, then you'll certainly want this whole collective series that you'll see here. And then also coming out, we have Last Gender, Volume 1. This is stories of sexual minorities gathering at like a chic spot called The Bar in California, and they're looking for love and, you know, going into like finding their sexuality as well. This is 18 plus, just so that you are aware.
And next, we continue with volume ones this month of October. Is number six, Manga Omnibus 1, volumes 1-3. The classic dystopian manga returns, experience the story of two boys who uncover a terrible conspiracy and turn city number six on its head. And this three collectible three-in-one omnibus editions featuring extra large pages includes volume one and three, like I mentioned before. And then second is SHWD. Volume one, a hard-boiled jury tale about two special agent women fighting supernatural horrors. And we continue with the Case of Files of Jeweler Richard, light novel, volume one. This highly acclaimed mystery tale about a young man teaming up with a handsome jewelry appraiser inspired on a popular anime and manga adaptation, also from Seven Seas. And then we have the Saint's Magic Power is Omnipotent, The Other Saint, manga volume one, a companion tale to the popular light novel manga and anime in English from Funimation. What would you do if everyone thought you were the chosen one, but you knew they were wrong?
And then continuing on with volume ones, we have The Summer You Were There, volume one. This is in the sweet Yuri love story by the creator of The Girl I Want Is So Handsome, which is also by Seven Seas. We have two high school girls, one a shy writer and the other a social butterfly, try to live out a romance novel. We also have The Titan's Bride, volume one. I really love this cover.
I love this cover. It's such an amazing cover.
As you can tell, if you didn't know about the cover,
yeah.
This is a mature rated boys love fantasy isekai that inspired an anime. There's nothing small about the love between a human and a titan prince. And then following that, we have Though I Am an Inept Villainous, Tale of the Butterfly Rat Body Swap in the Maiden Court light novel, volume one. Prepare for swirling court intrigue in this magical trading places tale of maidens competing for the crown. And don't miss the manga adaptation also from Seven Seas. And then we have this interesting title, Thunderbolt Fantasy Omnibus 1. So this collects volumes 1 to 2. And you don't want to miss out on this official manga adaptation for the international Wuxiao television phenomenon. A vicious warlord is on the hunt for a magic sword. Dan Fei has spent her whole life guarding the coveted sword of divine retribution. Legends say its power is great enough to smite demons and shake the heavens. She'll need to keep it away from evil hands.
Yes. And continuing with volume ones, we have Vivi Prototype Light Novel Volume 1, originally penned as a collaborative concept novel before production of the popular anime Vivi Fluorite Eyes Song, available streaming through Funimation. Don't miss this rich science fiction tale of an AI songstress and her 100-year mission to save humanity from the writers of ReZero and Chaos Child. Next, we have Yokai Cats Volume 1, a fun and full-color comic about supernaturally adorable cats from the creator of the evil secret society of cats, also from Seven Seas. And we end this section with the evil secret society of cats volume one, a hilarious full color manga about scheming cats from the creators of Yokai Cats, also from Seven Seas, like we mentioned. So put them both together.
Yes. And then we have some additional titles, continuations of series that is coming out in October. So we have, oh, I love this so much, by Square Enix, A Man and His Cat. This is volume 7. This is so sweet. Definitely recommend picking it up. Next up, as a reincarnated aristocrat, I'll use my appraisal skill to rise in the world. Oh, this is a volume 1. That should have gone
to the should have been in another slide, but that's fine.
That's all right. At least it's up front here.
And we don't have to read the description because the title is the description of what it is.
It is there, yes. It's in the title. Yeah. And then we have Attack on Titan. This is Omnibus 7. This collects volumes 19 to 21. And then we also have the final season part 2 manga box set for Attack on Titan as well. Baka Monogatari, this is the volume 16. And then we have Berserk of Gluttony. This is the light novel, volume 7. We also have Blackguard, volume 5. And the highly anticipated anime that's going to come out in the fall, right before the World Cup. So we have Blue Lock, volume 3. And then we also have Card Captor Sakura, Clear Card, volume 12, The Clamp. And then we have Cat Massage Therapy. This is volume 3.
Yes, and we continue with Creepy Cat, volume 4, by Cotton Valente. I believe she's from was it Philippines? I think so, or Taiwan. Sorry, I'm so sorry. But we read the volume one. It was amazing. So I highly recommend this. Dance in the Vampire Bund, Age of the Scarlet Order, volume 7. Eden Zero, one of my favorites, 19. Failure Frame, I Became the Strongest and Annihilated Everything with Low-Level Spells, like novel, volume 5. Then we have Fire Force 29. This, the next season is supposed to be coming soon. Grand Blue Dreaming 17, also one of my favorites. I was reincarnated as the seventh brain, so I can take my time perfecting my magical ability too. And then we have I'm in Love with the Villainous light novel, volume 6. And then another of my favorites and one of my favorite authors of recent times, Island in the Puddle 4 by Kay Sambe. And we finish this slide with It's Just Not My Night, Tale of a Fallen Vampire Queen, volume 2.
Continuing on, we have Kageki Shoujo, volume 7, Kimono Jihen, volume 2, Loner Life in Another World light novel, volume 3. And then we also have Love and Lies, volume 12, the Lina ending, and then we also have the Misaki ending as well. Lovesick Ellie, volume 6. Modern Villainous, It's Not Easy Building a Corporate Empire Before the Crash. This is the light novel, volume 2. We have Momo, the Blood Taker, volume 2. Mushoku Tensei, Jobless Reincarnation, light novel, volume 18. And My Isekai Life, volume 3.
And then we have Necromance, volume 5. Also, we have Orient, 10. And we also have Outbride, Beauty and the Beast, volume 2. We continue with Parallel Paradise, volume 11. And then we have Reincarnated as a Sword, manga, volume 9. And on the bottom left, you see Rent-A-Girlfriend, 14. Then we have Sakurai-san, Wants to Be Noticed, volume 2. And Sayonara Football, 13. And Servamp, volume 17. And then on the right and the bottom right, we have Shangri-La Frontier 2, one of my favorites. Recently, I talked about it, and I talked about it on last month's video also.
All right. And then continuing on, we have Sino Alice, volume 2, which is a lot of fun. Yeah. Something's Wrong with Us, volume 11, also fun. It has a live action drama. I'm into dramas. You know, I have to talk about that. Sundome, Milky Way, Volume 5. We have Suppose a Kid from the Last Dungeon, Boonies, Moved to a Starter Town, Volume 6, manga. Survival in Another World with My Mistress, light novel, Volume 3. That Time I Got Reincarnated as a Slime, Trinity in Tempest. This is the manga, Volume 6, that's coming out. In addition, oh gosh, another one that's a volume one, but this is the light novel of the Dawn of the Witch. Please note that the cover is not final for this one. We also have The Demon Girl Next Door, volume 6, The Ghost in the Shell, The Human Algorithm, volume 3, The Great Jay Will Not Be Defeated, volume 4.
And we continue with The Iceblade Sorcerer Shall Be Rule the World 2. Then we have the Idaten Deities Know Only Peace, volume 3. Then we have a box set for the quintessential quintuplets, part 2. And we continue with The Saint's Magic Power is Omnipotent, manga, volume 6. And also, we have The Seven Deadly Sins, Omnibus 6, which collects volumes 16 to 18. On the bottom left, we also have another omnibus, Shaman King Omnibus 11, which collects volumes 31 to 33. And we continue with The Strange Adventure of a Broke Mercenary, light novel, volume 6. Then we have The Witches of Adamas, volume 3. And then we have This is Screwed Up, But I Was Reincarnated as a Girl in Another World, manga, volume 3. And we finished this slide with Vampire Dormitory 7.
Then We also have One Dance Volume 3, Volume, I read Volume 1. It's a lot of fun as well.
So good.
Yes. And then we have Welcome to the Ballroom Volume 11. That cover is great.
Yeah, I love that cover. Yeah.
Like you wouldn't think with like a ballroom manga, but like how fierce it is. But I love it.
It is. Yeah.
We have Young Ladies Don't Play Fighting Games. This is Volume 3. And then Yuna, The Haunted Hot Springs, Volume 21, ending on this slide here.
And that's it. That's our presentation for this month of new releases coming in October for manga. As always, let us know if you have any questions. Like I said, if there's any questions about the rights or you need any information about more information about our mangas, feel free to reach out and follow us on our social media. We have social media on Facebook, on Instagram, and on Twitter under PRH Comics, PRH International Comics. Sorry. That's it for this week, for this month. See you next month with another list. Thank you.
Hi, everyone.